NASA confirmed mysterious reflections on Mars that shocks Elon Musk. In our solar system, Mars has received the greatest exploration. Mars, the planet located fourth from the Sun, is well known for its rusty red hue. A globe with very little atmosphere, the red planet is a frigid, arid world. The planet is far from boring, despite being dusty and, as far as we can tell, lifeless. It can get so cold that carbon dioxide in the atmosphere condenses directly into snow or frost on Mars, and extraordinary dust storms that are so enormous they cover the entire planet frequently shake things up. Mars quakes are also a common occurrence. Ancient Chinese astronomers referred to Mars as the Fire Star, and today's astronomers are still enthralled by the red planet's mysteries. There is still plenty to learn about Mars, despite the fact that hundreds of spacecrafts have been launched there. Most scientists still can't sleep at night due to the numerous unanswered questions surrounding the red planet. And the most recent finding is not an exception. What could this be that shocked even the SpaceX CEO, Elon Musk? Hello everyone, and welcome back to Elon Musk Evolution, where we bring you the most recent news about Elon Musk and his multi-billion dollar companies, space news, and the latest science and technology. But before we begin, make sure you subscribe to our channel and click the bell icon so you don't miss any of our amazing videos. And let's get started! A radar signal that could be interpreted as proof of liquid water was discovered in 2018, according to research using data from the Mars Advanced Radar for Subsurface and Ionosphere Sounding, or MARSIS. That instrument's on board the European Space Agency's Mars Express mission. ULTIMA SCOPULI, a location in the Martian South Pole, was the source of that signal, a peculiar bright reflection. According to their latest findings, the signal from the reflection may not have originated from the ice itself or even from liquid water, but rather from beneath ice geological layers consisting of minerals and frozen carbon dioxide. It was discovered that the unearthly reflection is specifically caused by the layer thickness rather than the material of the layer. On Earth, liquid water is a common source for stunning reflections like these. For instance, subglacial lakes like Lake Vostok in Antarctica, which has been buried under more than 3 kilometers of ice for millions of years, produce a strong radar signal akin to that of Mars. However, this does not prove that there is liquid water present on Mars, even if it is likely that something similar may have happened there as well. In order to unravel this puzzle, the research team employed computer simulations and radar data from MARSIS to determine how layers of ice and other minerals, such as basalt rock that was created following ancient volcanic eruptions on Mars, might respond to incoming light. The scientists created simulations. Dan LALICH, a planetary scientist at Cornell University and the study's primary author, made sure to include layers of this ice in the models because of the Martian South Pole has a tremendous amount of carbon dioxide stored there. The separation and thickness of layers, in addition to the presence of a layer of carbon dioxide ice beneath a layer of water ice, were shown to affect the strength of a reflection in one particular simulation. Certain minerals were also found to be able to produce a reflection similar to this in earlier investigations LALICH worked on. He thinks it's even possible for the ice layers that are covered by dust on the red planet. Regardless, the reflection can be made without any liquid water. I could have utilized rock layers or even exceptionally dirty water ice, and I would have achieved identical findings, the author claimed in a statement. This paper's main argument is that layer thickness and separations are more significant than the content of the base layers, he explained. However, the latest findings do not rule out the possibility that there may be liquid water present on Mars. None of our research has demonstrated that there is no liquid water present underneath, according to LALICH. I'm not sure anything short of a drill could show either side of this dispute conclusively right or wrong, the researcher said. We just think the interference hypothesis is more consistent with other facts. Water and perhaps even signs of life may still be hiding someplace, whether behind a glacier or far beneath the planet's burnt crimson surface. Galileo Galilei was the first to use a telescope to view Mars in 1610. Astronomers made the polar ice caps of the globe known in the century that followed. Some scientists in the 19th and 20th centuries, most notably Percival Lowell, thought they had discovered a system of long, straight canals on Mars that might have been evidence of a past civilization. These observations turned out to be inaccurate interpretations of geological features, nevertheless. Over the ages, a number of Martian rocks have fallen to Earth, giving scientists a unique chance to examine fragments of Mars without having to leave our planet. Allen Hills 84001, or ALH 84001, a Martian meteorite that is thought to contain small fossils and other signs of Martian life, was one of the most controversial discoveries. Other researchers have questioned this theory, but the team behind the well-known 1996 study has stuck with their conclusion, and the discussion concerning ALH 84001 is still going strong today. A different meteorite study from 2018 discovered that organic molecules, the carbon-containing building blocks of life, but not necessarily proof of life itself, may have arisen on Mars through chemical reactions akin to those in batteries. With the launch of Mariner 4 in 1964 and Mariner 6 and 7 in 1969 by the United States, robotic spacecraft started monitoring Mars in the 1960s. Early missions showed Mars to be a lifeless globe devoid of any indications of the civilizations or life that visionaries like Lowell had speculated might have existed there. Mariner 9 orbited Mars in 1971, charting nearly 80% of it and finding the planet's volcanoes and massive canyons. In the 1960s and the first few years of the 1970s, the Soviet Union launched a lot of spacecraft for the Red Planet, but the majority of those missions were unsuccessful. The successful operations of Mars 2 and Mars 3 in 1971 were hindered by dust storms, which prevented them from mapping the surface. The very first successful landing on Mars was made in 1976 when NASA's Viking 1 lander touched down. Viking 2, its identical twin, touched down on Mars 6 weeks after the first Viking. The first ever close-up images of the Martian surface were taken by the Viking landers, but they did not discover any compelling proof of life. Once more, there has been disagreement. Gil Levin, the lead researcher of the Vikings' labeled release life detection experiment, has consistently insisted that the landers discovered signs of microbial metabolism in the Martian soil. When he was 97 years old, Levin passed away in July 2021. Mars Pathfinder, a lander, and Mars Global Surveyor, an orbiter, two NASA spacecraft that were launched in 1996, were the following two missions to land on Mars successfully. The first wheeled rover to ever investigate the surface of another planet was a little robot named Sojourner that was aboard the Pathfinder spacecraft. For 95 Earth days, Sojourner traveled across the planet's surface studying rocks. The Mars Odyssey spacecraft, which NASA launched in 2001, found enormous volumes of water ice beneath the Martian surface, particularly in the upper 3 feet. Since the probe cannot see any deeper water, it's still unclear if there is additional water underneath. Mars came closer to Earth in 2003 than it had in any time in the previous 60,000 years. In the same year, NASA launched two golf cart-sized rovers known as Spirit and Opportunity, which, after landing on Mars in January 2004, examined various areas of its surface. Numerous hints that water formerly flowed across the planet's surface were discovered by both rovers. Phoenix was a lander that NASA launched in 2008 to explore the northernmost regions of Mars, and among other discoveries, the robot proved the presence of water ice in the nearby subsoil. The Mars Reconnaissance Orbiter and MAVEN, which arrived in Mars in 2006 and 2014 respectively, were two additional orbiters being used by NASA to study the planet. And both the Mars Express and the Trace Gas Orbiter are satellites operated by the European Space Agency in orbit around the planet. NASA successfully landed the Mars InSight lander in November 2018, which is analyzing Mars quakes to learn more about the interior structure and makeup of Mars. And then July 2020, NASA launched the Perseverance rover, which will search for life and store samples. In February of 2021, Perseverance, which is around the same size as Curiosity and Ingenuity, a tiny technology demonstrating helicopter, touched down on the surface of the Jezero crater on Mars. To transport people to the Moon, Mars, and other planets, SpaceX is creating a reusable rocket called Starship. And according to SpaceX CEO Elon Musk, a crewed mission to Mars could take place in 2029. And that's going to end today's episode. We hope you enjoyed our video. Please make sure you subscribe, like, and share, and we'll look for you next time. Thanks for watching.